Inside, we're approaching a mangrove island that is a very popular seabird hangout spot as well as a protected bird nesting area. Kind of a special time we're in right now because there's a bunch of baby kinds of birds, different seabirds all in this area, so we're going to take it easy and go for one full lap around and try to see what we can spot. In the beginning here, right off the right, we got some little white birds, which are called cantilevers. They're pretty fun to see dance around. Their hair flies up high in the air and they'll peck each other on the head and do kind of a dance as they're battling. The most common bird in here is called a brown pelican. It's kind of a larger size brown bird we have from around here. It's got a white head, it's got a giant mouth, and you see them crashing into the water from time to time. Also just on the right hand side of my boat, we got a couple of great blue herons. The great blue herons are much taller than the brown pelicans. They got kind of a grayish blue color. I believe those are the babies, actually. The babies that are just growing up and quite haven't made their way. And we do have a very rare sight up here that I just saw yesterday, but you have to kind of peek at it. Just on the right-hand side of my boat, way up on the top, we have some juvenile brown pelicans. And it's very, very rare to see baby pelicans. It's very rare. So we got some right at the nest, just on the right-hand side of my boat right now. We got an osprey hanging out just on the other end of the island right where I am now. He's in the middle of the trees just above the water. We call the birds osprey around here, but if you're in the northwest regions of the United States, they refer to them as sea hawks. That can be a pretty cool sight. They'll snatch a fish right out of the water with their talons. They'll take it to the nearest pylon and munch down.
to Tampa Bay. Straight out ahead of us, you'll notice the Golden Peaks of the Sunshine Skyway Bridge. The Sunshine Skyway Bridge is the flagship bridge of Florida. It is on the list of top 10 bridges in the world, according to the Travel Channel. It is number 3. This is the second version of the bridge. The first version got plowed into back in May of 1980 on a real stormy morning by a big 600-foot barge, taking out most of the bridge and causing cars to drive right off the end of it. We're going to pick up speed now and go for a run down Cerro Verde, get a much better shot of the Skyway Bridge, and then see what kind of seekers we can get to pop up in Mangrove Alley. Here we go. Very quickly out to the left. You want to make sure you stay between my boat and the dock, right in between my boat and the dock. It's very shallow, very quick out to the left.
Thank you.
nice big size spotted dolphin. There's about 12 or 13 of them underneath me right now. So we're going to circle around them, see if they want to put on a little show for us.
Thank you.
as well. Best to maintain a nice safe distance. Match fuel to the speed. Stay nice and hard because we came into some pretty abrupt speed changes coming through this area. And be sure to keep that head on a swivel because the boat could show up at any point.
Piling in your way across this beautiful St. Pete area. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you all for coming out. Hope you had a nice time. We're going to begin our docking procedure here shortly. I'll be sliding in and docking my boat first. In the meantime, y'all are going to hang out just outside the marina, doing the carousel motion that we did in the very beginning, taking it nice and easy out in the middle and avoid some boat traffic. And I'm going to give you a ring over the radio, walk you right on through your docking procedure, calling you in one at a time. And please do remember, if you enjoyed the ride, please tip your guide. 20% gratuity is appreciated. However, some customers do give more. We work for tips here as the guide at St. Pete Speedboat Adventures and Endless Summer Water Sports, and any extra is helpful.